Hello, future engineers. These are additional problems on strains. If you like my videos and my lecture videos, please energize and inspire me by sharing my videos to your friends and to your friends' friends. That's the only way you can support my channel to keep me going. So here is the first problem. A thin triangular plate is uniformly deformed as shown below. Compute the shearing strain at P associated with the two edges PQ and PR that were orthogonal in the undeformed plate. So the shearing strain by angular deformation is the total angular deformation at P. P was here, and we have here an additional deformation of 0.25 mm. That's why it is now at here position. So this distance, because the angle here is 90 degrees, so this is a right triangle. We have a vertical and horizontal line. So this is hypotenuse 125 cosine of 45 degrees, same is true here. And this vertical distance is 125 sine of 45 degrees. So that if we call this angle theta, and that is also theta, the total angular deformation would be, or the shearing strain would be 2 theta. Then in this right triangle, tangent of 45 degrees plus theta is equal to 125 sine 45 plus 0.25 over 125 cosine of 45. Then from there, we can solve for theta. So tangent of quantity 45 degrees plus theta is quantity 125 sine 45 plus 0.25 all over 125 cosine 45. So inverse tangent of this fraction, then minus 45 degrees, we can solve theta. So theta is 0.080914 degrees. So therefore, the shearing strain is 2 times theta expressed in radians. So shearing strain is 2 times 0.080914 degrees times pi radian over 180 degrees. So shearing strain is equal to 2.824 times 10 to the negative 3 radian, or you may also express it as 2,824 microradian. So that's it for this problem. I hope you were able to follow the solution. A rigid bar C is supported by two steel rods as shown below. There is no strain in the vertical bars before the load P is applied. After load P is applied, the actual strain in bar B is 0.0006 mm per mm. So determine the actual strain in bar A, and letter B, the actual strain in bar A if there is 0.025 mm clearance in the connection between A and C before the load is applied. So here is the figure. Because bar C is rigid, then after P is applied, it will deflect with straight, this neutral axis will remain straight, rotating about this pin here, frictionless pin here, as shown in the figure, denoted by this blue dash center line. And we will call this delta B, and this one as delta A. And take note that delta A initially has no initial strain or no clearance. So we can compute delta B from the given strain of 0.0006 mm per mm times the length. So delta B is strain in B times uniform strain in B times length of B. So we must express length of B in mm, which is 0.9 meter or 900 mm. So therefore, delta B is equal to 0.0006 mm per mm times 900 mm, or 0.0006 radian times 900 mm. So it is equal to 0.54 mm. Having found delta B, we can solve delta A by similar triangles. 0.54 as to 0.9 equals delta A as to 0.9 plus 1.5. Solving for delta A is equal to 1.44 mm. So therefore, the strain in A is delta A over length of A, 1.44 over 1,200 mm length of A. So the strain in bar A is equal to, the axial strain in bar A is equal to 0.0012 mm per mm. Then for part B, if there is a clearance of 0.025, so delta A therefore is 0.025 plus the additional strain of bar A, we will call it delta A prime. So delta A is delta A prime plus the clearance of 0.025. So imagine that this is equal to delta A prime plus 0.025. There's a clearance here of 0.025 mm. So the additional deformation that bar A has to elongate so that it will reach this point here is equal to delta A without clearance, then minus 0.025. So delta A prime is equal to delta A, which is 1.44 minus 0.025. So strain in A prime is equal to delta A prime over LA. So it is equal to quantity 1.44 minus 0.025 mm divided by 1,200 mm. So strain in A prime in part B is equal to 0.001179 mm per mm. A 6-meter section of steel railroad rail has a cross-sectional area of 7,500 mm square. Both ends of the rail are tight against adjacent rails that, for this problem, can be assumed to be rigid. The rail is supported against lateral movement. The coefficient of thermal expansion for the steel is 11.7 times 10 to the negative 6 per degrees Celsius. For an increase of temperature of 40 degrees Celsius, determine the maximum normal stress in the rail and the maximum shearing stress in the rail, the internal force on a cross-section of the rail. So this is the picture. We have a 6-meter rail. We assume that the ends are rigidly attached as mentioned in the problem, and it is laterally supported that there's no expansion laterally. So when the temperature is increased, imagine that we have this length will increase, supposedly will elongate, but elongation is prevented because of the fixed ends, so which causes thermal stresses, which is compression. So to view the elongation due to temperature increase, we have to extend it and apply the force P. So this is elongation due to thermal expansion, which is beta L delta T, where beta is the coefficient of thermal expansion, length, and delta T is the temperature change, final minus initial. And this is the resulting force, which is compressive stress times the area of cross-sectional area of the rail. So delta T is equal to delta, and delta T is beta L delta T, while change in temperature, while this delta here is equal to stress length over E. So beta L delta T is stress length over E, cancel out L. So the formula for stress is beta E delta T. So substituting, this is also the maximum compressive stress that will develop normal to the rail. Beta is 11.7 times 10 to the negative 6 per degree centigrade. E is 200 megapascals, and delta T is 40 degrees Celsius positive. So we can cancel degrees Celsius. The unit for sigma, which is equal to sigma max, is megapascals, and it is in compression. So 93.60 megapascals compression. We learned that the maximum shearing stress is half the maximum normal stress, and the angle between them is 45 degrees, remember, on inclined planes. So tau max is equal to half of sigma max. So substituting, tau max is equal to 93.6 divided by 2. So the maximum shearing stress in part B is 46.8 megapascals. And finally, the internal force on a cross-section of the rail, it is compressive stress times area, and the area is stress times area. The area is 7,500 mm². So 93.6 megapascals or newton per mm² times 7,500 mm², then divided by 1,000 newtons per kilonewtons. Let's express our answer in kilonewtons. So from there, we can compute the internal force on a cross-section of the rail in compression, and it is equal to 702 kilonewtons compression. A steel surveyor's tape 12.5 mm wide by 0.4 mm thick is exactly 30 meters long at 20 degrees Celsius under a pull of 45 newtons. What correction should be introduced if the tape is used to make a 30 meter measurement at a temperature of 40 degrees Celsius and under a pull of 90 newtons? Use modulus of elasticity of 200 gigapascals and beta, or coefficient of thermal expansion, 11.6 times 10 to the negative 6 per degree Celsius. So this is the tape. This has standard length of 30 meters. When the temperature is standardized at 20 degrees Celsius, and the pull is also standardized at 45 newtons. So it will extend if the pull is not 45 newtons and the temperature is not 20 degrees Celsius. So we expect that it will lengthen, elongate further because the temperature is increased to 40 degrees Celsius and the pull is also increased to 90 newtons. So this is due to the pull, which has a net value of 90 minus 45 or 45 newtons. And this is due to temperature increase, which is 40 minus 20 or 20 degrees Celsius. So the total deflection correction should be denoted by delta sub C, and it consists of delta plus delta T, where delta is P minus PO, length over AE. So delta C is P minus PO times length over AE plus beta L delta T. So substitute, P is 90 newtons minus 45 newtons times length of 30,000 mm. Divided by 12.5 mm, cross-sectional area is 12.5 mm wide for the tape by 0.4 mm thick. So you may relate this with your surveying subject. Then E is 200,000 megapascals or 200,000 newton per mm². Then beta 11.6 times 10 to the negative 6, length 30,000 mm, delta T 40 minus 20. So all these terms will give us unit of mm. So the final answer would be an mm. So the total correction should be 8.310 mm or 0.00831 mm. So the end of the tape, the 30 meter end will now be here. So when you measure a certain length and the length is 30, it is not 30, but it is 30 plus this total correction. So this is the actual measured length if if you use this tape and the pull applied would be 90 newtons and the temperature existent during the measurement is 40 degrees Celsius, so you have to add the correction. Because the end of the 30 meter tape will appear to be here. So that's it for this problem. You just make this as the final answer because this is the required in this problem. So determine the extension due to its own weight of the homogeneous conical bar shown below. Express the result in terms of L, length, E, and the specific weight gamma of the material. Assume that the taper of the bar is light enough for the assumption of a uniform axial stress distribution over a cross section to be valid. And so this is the figure and the stress is not uniform unless we consider a strip. So let's have that horizontal strip at distance y from the vertex, so the thickness is dy, so that below this, because this is fixed at the top, below this strip here is the weight of this conical part which pulls the cross-sectional area, varying cross-sectional area. So the thickness is dy and that is x, so that let's call this wx, which is the weight of this conical part below the strip, and the tension in the upper surface of this strip will also be equal to Wx by equilibrium. So let's now isolate this strip here of thickness dy. So this is Wx, that's also Wx, that's dy, and the radius is x as shown in the figure. So the formula for the deformation is by integration because the elongation, the stress is not uniform, but it will only be uniform at this level of the strip or strip. So deformation equals integral of pdy over ae. The original formula is pdx over ae, but in this case, the length is in that direction, so that's why it is dy. Where p is wx, and wx is equal to gamma times volume of the cone below this strip, which is volume of cone is pi radius, which is x square times length or height y over 3. So that is p. While area is the area of the circle, which is also pi x square. So substitute into the formula above, deformation equals integral 0 to L of gamma pi x square y over 3 dy over pi x square times e. So we can cancel pi x square. So we put the constants before the integral sign, and that is deformation equals gamma over 3e, then integral of y dy from 0 to L. So integral of y dy is y square over 2, so gamma over 3e, quantity y square over 2 from 0 to L. So simplifying, this is gamma over 6e, quantity upper limit L square minus lower limit 0 square. So therefore, the deformation due to the weight of this cone is equal to gamma L square over 6E. So that's it. These are the 5 additional problems on strains, and I think there were also 27 or 28 problems for strains. So that make it 33 problems all in all. So I hope that the problems, all the 33 problems on strains are enough for you to be exposed on the different situations all about strains. And you find more problems, not only in YouTube, but also in other books, other sources, so that you can understand further the concept on strains.